everybody. My name is Killian Mitchell. I'm a product marketing manager for Power BI at Microsoft. And today I'll be giving you an overview of how you can unleash your Dynamics 365 data with Azure Synapse Analytics and Power BI. With me today, we also have Scott Sewell, a principal program manager on the Power BI CAT team. We'll then take over and give you a demonstration on how exactly all these products actually work together. So let's dive in. To set the scene a little, we've heard over and over again that our customers are facing an unprecedented landscape of challenges and unpredictability, from rapidly changing customer preferences to supply chain disruptions to a dramatic shift in working from home. This is actually my second day back in the office in 2 years. So, you know, with this constant instability, decision makers can rely less and less on past experience to help them navigate the market. Instead, they need to look towards the huge amount of data that departments generate and capture every day, and adopt the analytics tools and data culture needed to ensure everyone in their organization can uncover meaningful insights from their data and make more informed decisions. An enormous source of this data comes from the business applications that your organization uses. Now, since you're listening to this webinar, I'm guessing your organization likely uses some Dynamics 365 apps in at least one department. But if you're like many of our customers, you might also have other business applications like SAP or Salesforce, or maybe you even created some custom apps using the Power Apps platform. These business apps connect your processes and teams together, generating data on every aspect of your business, from marketing telemetry to customer service interactions to financial transactions. This data can be an invaluable source of insights, but only if you have the right analytics and business intelligence engine to uncover them. You need to be able to ingest, prepare, transform, and serve this data quickly, and then connect it to a powerful BI platform. Only then can you put it in the hands of every decision maker across your organization and empower them to uncover insights critical to the day-to-day responsibilities. Because the right insights can transform departments. Sellers can get a 360-degree view of customers to personalize their interactions. Customer service managers can then analyze customer sentiment across channels and identify key opportunities for improvement. Finance managers can discover new growth and cost drivers by uncovering patterns across their financial data. And because of this huge potential, each line of business is being asked to do more and be more data-driven, and then in turn putting an enormous pressure on data teams to help them make that a reality. But you know, this is all easier said than done. Data teams face a ton of challenges in setting something like this up, including data silos and siloed approaches to data integration, using separate services at each stage of the analytics workload, organizational silos between data teams, skill silos between data engineers who prefer working in different languages. And obviously, there's a need to provide enterprise-grade security at each stage of this process. And that's why we're working hard to simplify this process. By seamlessly integrating Dynamics 365, Azure Synapse Analytics, and Power BI, you can now query Dynamics 365 data in near real time and at limitless scale, and then turn that data into an interactive storytelling experience in Power BI, and even embed it in Dynamics 365 to make it accessible to all. Essentially, you can create a continuous data pipeline from your Dynamics 365 applications that can easily handle petabytes of information, analyze it, and visualize it in Power BI. But I think I should probably pause there and explain what I'm talking about. What is Azure Synapse Analytics? So Azure Synapse Analytics is a limitless analytics service that brings together data integration, enterprise data warehousing, and big data analytics. Synapse brings these three worlds together in a unified experience to ingest, explore, prepare, transform, manage, and serve this data for immediate BI and machine learning needs. I should also explain what Dataverse is, because I know Scott will talk a lot about it, and it's critical to our story. So Dataverse is the underlying data platform for all Dynamics 365 applications and the Power Platform. The goal of Dataverse is to help you easily structure your business data across applications in a secure and compliant manner. Now, in the past, if an organization wanted to discover deep insights from the data within Dataverse, it required stitching together a whole bunch of services. This created a barrier between business application data and analytics systems by constantly copying data back and forth, slowing down time to insight and requiring constant maintenance and adjustments. That's why we've created Azure Synapse Link for Dataverse. Azure Synapse Link for Dataverse makes everything I've been talking about possible. With just a few clicks, you can create a continuous pipeline from your Dataverse data to Azure Synapse Analytics and rapidly start analyzing and visualizing your data. Now, normally when you want to take your data from Dataverse and move it into a place where you can do analytics on top of it, you have to extract, transform, and load the data, which can be very time intensive, cost intensive, and complexity intensive. Azure Synapse Link for Dataverse simplifies this ETL process. Instead of copying the data constantly back and forth, you just set it up once. It automatically runs the ETL process and sends the data to an informational store where analytics can happen on top of it. Any new data that comes in follows the same process in near real time. Then other applications or platforms you're using, like Power BI, can call into the store immediately, helping you turn this data into insights and action quickly. Now, I'll turn it over to Scott, who will show you a demo of how this all works.
Hello, I'm Scott Sewell. I'm a principal program manager on the Microsoft Power BI CAT team, but I've been working with Dynamics 365 for nearly 20 years. I've seen firsthand how much rich data is sitting inside the Dataverse platform, and I've also seen how customers are using that data for reporting and analytics to drive improved sales, richer customer experiences, as well as improve the experience and the usage for their own teams. Today, I want to show you how Dynamics 365 can work seamlessly with Azure Synapse Link and for enriching and building out that reporting data, as well as displaying it using Power BI. I'm excited to show you what we have available to you right now. So let's get started. Each day, as our users are interacting with Dynamics 365, whether through the customer service app, where they're capturing service cases, or the marketing app, where they're running marketing campaigns, or in this case, the sales app, where we're capturing sales opportunities, they're looking at a lot of data, they're processing it, they're updating it, they're adding new records to it, associating records with each other. All that information becomes this really rich source of data that we could use to learn from and improve and report on so that we can make better decisions off of that. Built into the application now is a new feature called Visualize as View. So in this case, I'm looking at a view called Opportunities, and inside the Opportunities, I see that I want to see a visual representation of what's going on in those opportunities. Now, this is a quick way of visualizing that with a Power BI report that's built directly onto that view. This is a quick report that allows me to interact with it. I can highlight and see the cross-filtering. I can even see the text narrative that's being automatically derived out of this. Now, I don't have to do anything to set this up. It's an automatic, quick report that's being created. But I might want to go further than that. I might want to look at a bigger picture. I can see an embedded report, a Power BI report embedded into the Dynamics 365 app like this sales pipeline. Now, a Power BI report can be built directly over Dataverse, the underlying data platform underneath Dynamics. It can be built there and I can service it right here, but I might want to go further and see much larger sets of data and in fact improve the data by supplementing it from data from other systems so that it can have this really rich interaction. I'll come back to this report in a moment, but let's take a look at how we can get the data there so that we can take advantage of it. Well, built into the Power Platform now is a new feature called Azure Synapse Link. Azure Synapse Link allows me with a few clicks to set up a continual data pipeline that writes out from Dataverse out to an Azure Data Lake. The Azure Data Lake is a really inexpensive way to store massive amounts of data in a way that's easy to gather and hold on to so you can then run an analysis across that. It really only takes a few clicks to set up a new link, and I would highlight this and say, here's the subscription, here's the resource group I want to use. All those things, once I've completed that, I'll have the ability to start adding tables to it. In this case, I've got my tables already set up and synchronizing. And again, as users make changes in Dataverse, automatically that goes into a pipeline that updates the data lake underneath it. And this data lake, then I can run reports off of. Now in the past, data lake, using a data lake was a bit more technical approach or technical challenge, but with Azure Synapse in front of it, we can automatically set up a workspace that allows us to ingest that data explore it, analyze it, and then prepare it for Power BI. So let's look at how that data shows up here. It actually shows up as if it was a full SQL database, but it's really a serverless table, a serverless SQL table. And here's my account table. When I highlight that, I could choose to run a SQL statement against it, and really a simple query way of accessing that. I could set up a data, load it into a data frame for more advanced analysis with Spark and some other more advanced tools that we have available. Or I can even set up a machine learning environment that could train a new model against that data where I run regression analysis against it, or classify the data where I'm grouping characteristics of the data together to really better visualize it. I could run time series forecasting against that to look further down the line and say, how do I predict what's going on? All that is a way of enriching the data that we've pulled out of Dataverse, possibly supplementing it with data from other parts of our data estate in the business, even supplementing it with data from outside the business, such as weather data or demographic data from other third-party subscription services. That data can be brought together, summarized, it can be fed directly back into Dataverse in some cases where I want to enrich the data that's there, or I can pull it out and make it a part of a Power BI report. In this case, I've got a Power BI report sitting on top of that Azure Synapse Analytics workspace. And this Power BI report just gives me a visual of how do I see the accounts, the opportunities, the contacts, et cetera, in that. And I can bring that and then publish it directly back into Dynamics. So this is what it looks like when I publish it back here. I can interact with it in really interesting ways that really summarize and build value into that data. Like in this case, I'm looking at the pipeline. I can cross highlight. I can look at the products. And like if I'm looking at the e-reader pen or the diamond 7-inch display, I can click on that, have a pop-up that's pulling additional data in so I see it in context of what I'm looking for. I can look at the team and the users. I can even go further and say, let me understand what the win-loss ratio is for individual salespeople. Now, I've taken this data, summarized it, and said, show me the data, show me the sales close ratios for each of the individuals. And I see from that summarized data that Spencer here, Spencer and Mia and Eric and even Alicia might have a little bit of a challenge and they're closing their opportunities. And so to help them do better or help them achieve their goals, I can identify them and then take action on them directly by saying, I want to enroll these in maybe a follow-up training or a coaching session by using the embedded Power Automate. I can send that out, make sure that I'm taking advantage of data that I found and summarized and now taking action on it. I can go further into it by looking at trend analytics across the data and saying, what does my sales pipeline look if it follows the same seasonality trends that I've had in the past? I'll see that further. Or if I look at days of sales that might have had an unusual spike in data, an unusual spike in volume there, I can see revenue one was unexpectedly high on a particular date at a value of $277,000. But really that can be attributed to possibly the owner of Eric, of opportunities of those Eric was Eric, and he had an unusually high revenue those days. Or maybe it was through a major farm or Ethan or the Southeast. Anyway, those are ideas in which we can then go further and understand the spikes in data that help us take advantage of those. We can look at insights to be able to figure out what's driving particular outcomes, like whether the sales opportunity in percentage close ratio is increasing or decreasing. We can see really we're doing well with transportation services, or the campaign is the marketing trends newsletter. I can look at combinations of segments. Like this combination is the product is something other than a particular reader, and the purchase process is unknown, and the value is less than $6,000. We see that as an area where we're having really strong confluence of those factors are driving success. We can look at the velocity of our sales pipeline, whether it takes longer to close those opportunities or not. Or we can even look at sales discounting. All of these things are outcomes that we may want to be measuring or are looking to. And if it's in a customer service environment, you may want to be looking at how long it takes to close a customer service case, or how many times does it get escalated before it gets resolved, or what is the customer satisfaction score coming back. And we can take that, look at all the components that may make up bits and pieces of it, and weight those accordingly so that we understand exactly which factors are driving success towards the goal we want to measure, and which ones may be common, but they're not really moving the needle that much. It's really powerful analysis that really that doesn't take any programming. It's just click and drag and drop set up this key influencer. We can look at the decomposition tree, where we start taking a value and breaking it out into its component parts, like the devices. We can see what products make that up, or within a product, we can break it out into the territory that is associated with it. And from the territory, we can even go further into who is the owner of those records. A quick way of seeing what is the components of this model that we're making out. We can do quick analysis and use the text analytics to understand what's going on within the data, and ask questions just using English. But even further than that, we may want to look inside of an individual record. So we've brought this together at that aggregate level, but what if we're looking at an individual customer like the Abbott group? If I open up the Abbott group record, I can see the data that's already been collected about them that the users are processing. That's very standard stuff that we're doing inside of Dynamics 365. But we can add into it a tab for just analytics, where we build in a Power BI report that's filtered to just this specific record. We've seen a lot of success with customers doing this because this is a quick way they can pull data from lots of parts of their application, summarize it in the reports that they have, and present it in the context of the record they're working with. So if I'm interacting with the Abbott group, I have visibility into inventory systems or ERP systems or sales or service or other systems that are completely unrelated, maybe a financial system that's giving me visibility into what our relationship is with Abbott Group. And I can have an informed conversation with Abbott Group when I'm doing that, by making this platform kind of a center of universe where we're seeing data from all systems being brought together so I can make informed and intelligent decisions. All this is possible because of the power and the interconnectivity of this Power Platform. I'm excited about the future and what we're seeing customers do to take advantage of this platform to solve really interesting business problems. And I look forward to working with you to solve those too.
Thanks so much, Scott. Now, some of the biggest brands in the world have already done what Scott just showed and combined these solutions and have achieved some amazing results. I highly encourage you to check out the Microsoft customer stories to find some of these examples. I also encourage you to get your hands dirty and try it yourself. Luckily, you can try both Power BI and Azure Synapse for free by going to the Power BI or Azure Synapse homepages, or simply typing in these AKA links on the slide. You can also learn more about the Azure Synapse link for Dataverse by using the AKA link, or simply finding it in Microsoft Docs. All right, that's all from us, folks. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to us, and we are very much looking forward to hearing about all the cool things you do with these products.